Hi everyone, welcome back to the SAM Biology classes online. I am Salim. Today we are going to study another one important concept of evolution, that is mutation theory. As I told you, there are many theories which explains about the evolution. The first important theory is Lamarckism. Then theory of natural selection, nothing but Darwin theory, and the third important theory is mutation theory. This mutation theory was proposed by Hugo de Vries in 1902, and you remember Hugo de Vries coined the term mutation. You know that mutation means the change in the DNA or genetic makeup of an individual, or you can say the changes occurring in the genetic material are referred as a mutation, and this mutation word was coined by Hugo de Vries. And this theory was proposed by him based on his observation on the plant Onothera lamarckiana. It is also called evening primrose is the common name, and the scientific name is Onothera lamarckiana. And the important characteristics of this theory I am going to explain you now. In exam you can get the question like characteristics or postulates of mutation theory, both are same. The first important characteristic is mutations are appear from time to time among the naturally breeding population or species. So mutations can appear from time to time. Okay, so samayakke anusaravagi ee mutation galu, mutation means nothing but changes are occur in naturally reproducing, breeding means nothing but naturally reproducing species or population. And the organisms with mutations are called mutants. Mutants means the organisms with mutation. And the second important postulate is mutations arise suddenly. So de Vries states that the mutations arises suddenly in only one step. So this is the another important point. And third important point is mutations are heritable. Heritable means they can be transmitted to the next generation and helps in the formation of new species. As I told you, according to Darwin, the new species is formed by the natural selection, whereas according to de Vries, the new species formation takes place because of the mutations, and mutations are sudden changes that occurs in only one step or single step. I hope I was clear with these three postulates. Now the next postulate is mutations are occurs in all possible directions. So mutation can occur in any direction. Okay, for example, if you take the neck of the giraffe, so it is a shorter one in the olden days or ancient times, and the modern giraffes are having long neck. So it is a gradual increase, or this change takes place from short to long. It is a directional change. But whereas mutations are directionless, they can take place in any way, in any direction. There is no systematic, like for example, I will tell you generally, like, so if you take the number 2, 4, 6, 8, so it is a gradual increase. But mutations are not like that. 2, suddenly 8, it will go back to 4, again 6, then 10, like this. So there is no any direction. So the mutations are directionless in nature, and they can occur in any direction or any all possible direction. And sometimes the mutations are advantageous, and in some cases the mutations are disadvantages. So for example, if an organism having a mutation, If it helpful for the organism, it is called advantageous mutation. If it is harmful for the organism, it is referred as a disadvantageous mutation. And usually the disadvantageous mutations are very dangerous and they can cause even death also. So that's why we can call it lethal mutation. That's why we use the word lethal mutation. So it is a disadvantageous mutation because it can lead to the death of the organism. So therefore, you have to remember the mutation may be advantageous or disadvantageous. And usually, the unsuitable mutants are destroyed by the natural selection. As I told you, only the useful mutants are selected by the nature and unsuitable mutants are destroyed by the natural selection. So this is very important postulate of the mutation theory. The another important postulate is mutations are large. The mutations are very large and random. They randomly occur and spontaneous. Spontaneous means sudden. So you have to remember three important words. Mutations are large, random, and they are spontaneous. Spontaneous means, as I told you, they occur suddenly. And therefore, mutations are called the raw material for evolution. So mutations are the raw material for the evolution. Then last postulate is mutations are full-fledged. What is the meaning of full-fledged is, say for example, you know that if organism has, take example of human evolution, you know that there are different stages are there. Okay, but mutations are full-fledged, it means there is no any intermediate stage. So there is no chances of presence of intermediate or intermediate stages during the evolution. So there is a direct change from one organism to the another organism and there is no any intermediate stages. So that is referred as full-fledged, meaning there is no intermediate stages. Okay, so these are the important characteristics or postulates of mutation theory. Now we are going to discuss briefly about the criticisms or objections or limitations of mutation theory. This mutation theory does not explain the presence of flightless birds on oceanic islands. You know that some oceanic islands are having the flightless birds. For example, you know that the example for flightless birds is a penguin, kiwi, okay. So these are the example for the flightless birds. And this theory is unable to explain the presence of flightless birds on oceanic islands. And this theory is also unable to explain the discontinuous distribution among the individuals. You know that there are two types of distribution, continuous distribution and discontinuous distribution. But this theory does not explain about the discontinuous distribution among the individuals. And the major objection was Oenothera lamarckiana, it is a hybrid plant. And this plant has an abnormal type of chromosome behavior or anomalous type of chromosome behavior. Okay, so this is the major objection that it is a hybrid plant and this plant has an anomalous type of chromosomes behavior. So this is also another criticism. And one more criticism is it could not explain the evolution. So it does not explain the process of evolution, only it provided the raw material for evolution, as I told you here. So mutations are the raw material for the evolution, but it could not explain how exactly the evolution has occurred. So these are the four major criticism or objections of mutation theory. So I hope you understood this concept. If you understood, like the video, subscribe the channel, comment on it. Thank you very much.